Today, we will see about the partial fraction. Partial fraction is very, very important article because there is a one unit in M3. The name of the unit is a Laplace transform. In Laplace transform, the role of partial fraction is very, very important. To finding the inverse of Laplace transform, special unit article, that name of the article is the partial fraction. By using the partial fraction, how to find the inverse Laplace transform? So before starting this partial fraction, we will see some basic concept related to the partial fraction. What is the use of partial fraction? In the denominator, there are two terms are in multiply. For expanding them or to separating them, the partial fraction is very, very important. So, before starting this partial fraction, we will start the basic concept related to the partial fraction, that is polynomial. So, today we will see about the partial fraction. So, this is the partial fraction. For partial fraction, we require the polynomial. A polynomial is a function. What is the meaning of polynomial? Polynomial is a function made up of one or more power functions added. Our simple definition of this polynomial is that polynomial is an expression containing variables arbitrary constant constant and arithmetic operation. So we'll see what is the meaning of this. Polynomial is an expression containing variables. Variables means what? As like x, y, z. Those alphabets are very, that is called as a variable. Arbitrary constant means what? Alphabets but which belongs to in a constant. And constant means what? As like numbers, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, integers, as like this. And arithmetic operations means what? Addition, subtraction, multiplication. That combination of this all is called as the polynomial. So we'll see the example. For example, 3x square plus 2x plus 5. So this is the polynomial. So 5, 2, 3 is a constant, x square, x is a variable, addition is that is a operation. So this is a combination of this all is called as the polynomial. After we will see the, what is the meaning of degree? What is the meaning of degree of polynomial? Highest coefficient, highest power in polynomial of the variable is called as degree of polynomial. So we'll see some examples. Example number first, polynomial generally denoted by f of x or p of x. P of x. P of x is equal to 3x plus 5. So this is the polynomial. Here there are only two terms, first term, second term. Second term is constant, first term 3x. 3 is a constant. So what is the power of this x? 1. Hence, degree of this polynomial is 1. This is called as a monic polynomial. Monic polynomial. Next, P of x is equal to 3x square 2x plus 5. So here 3 terms, 1, 2, 3. So its degree is 0, its degree is 1, its degree is 2. So highest power is 2. So this is called as a binomial, polynomial. Binomial polynomial. Or quadratic polynomial. We'll see the example about the third. Suppose P of x is equal to 3x cube 2x square 5x plus 6. So here contain 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. So degree of this is a 3. Highest is 0. Highest here degree is 0. Here 1, here 2, here 3. Hence degree is 3. This is called as a cubic polynomial. This is called as the cubic polynomial. After that, we will see about the partial fractions. There are two types of partial fraction. First is the proper partial fraction. Proper. And second is improper. Improper. Firstly, you have to understand what is the meaning of proper and improper. Before that, firstly to understand what is the meaning of denominator and numerator. Suppose expression is in that way, x by y. So x is the numerator and y is the denominator. X la kaam aisa hota hai numerator and y la kaam aisa hai denominator. So we will start from first, that is proper fraction. That is very, very important. Proper fraction is important. When simple, first I will explain, this is a numerator and this is a denominator. If degree of numerator is less than degree of this denominator, then that is called as the proper fraction. If degree of this numerator is greater than degree of this denominator, that is called as the improper. म्हणजे x ची डिग्री ही y पेक्षा कमी असेल तर त्याला म्हणायचं असते प्रॉपर फ्रॅक्शन. सी हियर, प्रॉपर फ्रॅक्शन. आणि जर y ची डिग्री x पेक्षा जास्त असेल तर त्याला म्हणत असते इम्प्रॉपर. आपण याला दुसऱ्या भाषेमध्ये म्हणतो हे अप्पर साईडचा पार्ट, हा म्हणू आपण लोअर साईडचा पार्ट. ओके, आणि राईट हियर, व्हेन द डिग्री of the polynomial in the numerator is strictly less than the degree of polynomial strictly less than the degree of polynomial polynomial in denominator then that fraction is called as the fraction is called as proper fraction. So for example, see here x divided by x plus 1 x plus 2. See here degree of this term is 1. Degree of this term is 1. 1 plus 1, do its addition. 1 plus 1 is 2. And here its degree is 1. So, degree of this denominator is greater than degree of this numerator. Hence, it is called as the proper fraction. So, example number, we will see about the improper. So, take its inverse. Improper fraction. Means what? Degree, I will write shortly here. Degree of denominator is less than degree of numerator. So, for example, x to the power 4 divided by x to the power 3 plus 1. Here its degree is 4, its degree is 3. So, degree of this numerator is greater than degree of this denominator. Hence, this is called as a improper fraction. In our study, the use of proper fraction is useful. So, we'll see the what is the proper fraction, how to find, what are the rules of this. Rules to finding the rules to finding partial fraction. So there are generally four rules to finding the partial fraction. Firstly, I will take here first rule, then we will see an example, then we will see the its remaining rules. If every linear factor, rule number first, linear factor of the form, here P of x is equal to AX plus B Cx plus d, this can be expressed in the form of a by ax plus b, b divided by cx plus d. What is the use of this partial fraction? Is that ax plus b and cx plus d, these both terms in this denominator are in multiply. To separating them, have to use the partial fraction. So use काय आहे? तर हे जे lower side जे दोन term multiply मध्ये आहेत, ते term multiply मध्ये असलेले term separate करण्यासाठी आपण partial fraction use करतो. मग हे separate करायची काय आवश्यकता आहे? बरेच असे ठिकाणी आपण असेल अशा ठिकाणी ज्या ठिकाणी की आपण for example derivative मध्ये आपण असे जर दोन term multiply मध्ये असतील तर आपण derivative काढू शकत नाही. जसे दोन टर्म जरा मल्टिप्लाय मध्ये असतात पण इंडिकेशन काढू शकत नाही. अशा वेळेस आपल्याला हे दोन टर्म सेपरेट करणं खूप गरजेचं असते. मग त्या वेळेस किंवा तर फॉर एग्जांपल आपण M3 मध्ये लॅपलास ट्रान्सफॉर्मर, मग त्या ठिकाणी आपल्याला बरंच दोन टर्म जरा मल्टिप्लाय मध्ये असतील डिनोमिनेटर मध्ये, तर त्या ठिकाणी आपल्याला लॅपलास ट्रान्सफॉर्म हे काढता येत नाही. म्हणजे आपल्याला काय करावं लागेल, तर ते सेपरेट करून घ्यावं लागेल. मग सेपरेट करण्यासाठी काय आहे, तर हा पार्शियल फ्रॅक्शन हा एकमेव रूल आहे जेणेकरून की आपण त्याला सेपरेट, दुसरे पण रूल आहेत पण हा थोडा सोपा रूल आहे जेणेकरून की ते आपल्याला सेपरेट करता येतील. तर हा रूल नंबर फर्स्ट, ज्यावर आपण एक्झाम्पल बघू नंतर मग रिमेनिंग रूल्स आपण पाहायचं आहे. सो एक्झाम्पल ऑफ धिस पार्शियल फ्रॅक्शन इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इझी. वी विल सी दॅट हाऊ टू फाईंड. सपोज एक्स प्लस वन डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स प्लस टू एंड हेअर एक्स प्लस थ्री. देर इज नीड टू फाइंड सेपरेटिंग देम. मीन्स वॉट? एक्स प्लस टू, एक्स प्लस थ्री, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ न्यूमरेटर, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिनोमिनेटर. सो देर इज नीड टू सेपरेटिंग देम. सो फर्स्टली बाय यूजिंग द रूल्स ऑफ पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन, डू ए डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स प्लस टू बी डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स प्लस थ्री. आफ्टर दॅट सेपरेटिंग देम, दिस ए अँड बी आर द आर्बिटरी कॉन्स्टंट. सो देर इज नीड टू फाइंड द व्हॉट इज द फिक्स कॉन्स्टंट. आता ह्या ज्या ए आणि बी हे जे आहेत हे आर्बिटरी कॉन्स्टंट आहेत. आता आपल्याला काय करायचं आहे, पुढची जी कॅल्क्युलेशन जे आहे ती कॅल्क्युलेशन यूज करून आपल्याला ए आणि बी ची व्हॅल्यू काढायचा. व्हॉट इज द मेन टार्गेट आफ्टर सेपरेटिंग दिस टू टर्म? आवर मेन टार्गेट इज दॅट टू फाइंड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस ए एज वेल एज दिस इज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ बी. एव्हरी वन रिमेंबर दॅट दिस इज अ व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट आर्टिकल, बिकॉज वन क्वेश्चन ऑन इन्वर्स लॅपलास ट्रान्सफॉर्म विल कंपल्सरी इन एम थ्री. सो फॉर धिस द पार्शियल फ्रॅक्शन इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. आय विल एक्सप्लेन हिअर. सो आवर मेन टार्गेट इज दॅट टू फाइंड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ ए अँड बी. टू फाइंडिंग द ए अँड बी we will do the next calculation. So solution of this problem is that firstly multiply x plus 2 x plus 3 on this both equations. What will get then? ata apna adding kay karaycha hai, x plus 2 and x plus 3 ne purna equation la multiply karaycha hai. Kay bhetal ma apnala? Upper side la x plus 1, multiply this x plus 1 to x plus 2 x plus 3, then upper side x plus 2 x plus 3 and lower side x plus 2 x plus 3 will cancel. सो मल्टीप्लाय आफ्टर ए, मल्टीप्लाय ए बाय एक्स प्लस टू एक्स प्लस थ्री, देन एक्स प्लस टू, एक्स प्लस टू विल कॅन्सल, देन यू विल गेट हेअर एक्स प्लस थ्री. सो बी इंटू ऑल्सो मल्टीप्लाय बाय बी, बीला पण आपल्याला पूर्ण इक्वेशनला मल्टीप्लाय करायचं आहे आपल्याला एक्स प्लस टू एक्स प्लस थ्री ने. बीला मल्टीप्लाय केल्यानंतर एक्स प्लस थ्री कॅन्सल होऊन जाईल, राहिलं का एक्स प्लस टू. आफ्टर दॅट our remember that our main target is that to find the value of a and b. To finding the a and b we are doing this calculation. Firstly put coefficient of this a equal to 0. X plus 3 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to minus 3. Put in this equation, this is called equation number 1. This is called equation number 1. After that, this is called equation number 2. So put the value x plus, x is x plus, that is coefficient of a is x plus 3. X plus 3 is equal to 0 implies x is equal to minus 3. Put in equation number 2. Then you will get minus 3 plus 1, that is x is equal to minus 2. So a into minus 3 plus 3, 0. B into minus 3 plus 1, that is minus 1. Do this simple calculation. Then you will get minus 2 is equal to a into 0, 0, that is minus b. So b is equal to 2. This is the value of b. After finding the value of b, we will calculate the value of a. So what is the firstly we have putting the x plus 3 equal to 0. After that we will put x plus 2 is equal to 0. Put x plus 2 is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to minus 2 in equation number 2. Then see here equation number 2, put here x is equal to minus 2, then you will get minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Here put x is equal to minus 2, minus 2 plus 3, that is a into 1. Put here x is equal to minus 2, minus 2 plus 2, 0. that is b into 0. Hence, a is equal to minus 1. Remember that value of a is minus 1. Value of b is 2. The value of a and b put in equation number 1. What is equation number 1? See here, equation number 1 is this. So, equation number 1. So, this is equation number 1. And we know that value of a is minus 1 and value of b is 2. From equation number 1 is that x plus 1 divided by x plus 2 x plus 3. So a divided by x plus 2 b divided by x plus 3. So value of a is 2, put here value of a is 2 divided by x plus 2 and value of b is minus 1 divided by x plus 3. So this is equation is that x plus 1 divided by x plus 2 and here x plus 3. So this is a 2 divided by x plus 2 minus 1 divided by x plus 3. So this is the, after separating you will get this. So what is the use of this partial fraction is the, this both terms are in multiply to separating them. See here, this term, one of something constant divided by x plus 2, this is separate term. Here something plus or minus, minus 1, that is divided by x plus 3. So after separating these two term, you can find derivative, integration, Laplace transform, like that. So we will see about the rule number second. What is the rule number second? In rule number first, see here, these two terms are in multiply and these both terms are in different form. Suppose one of this term is repeated, then in this case you have to use the rule number second. But rule number first madhe kaha ax plus b and cx plus d, he don term ahet ani doni term kashe ahet different ahet, pan जेव्हा दोन्ही टर्म पैकी एखादी टर्म रिपीट झाला असेल तर त्यावेळेस आपल्याला रूल नंबर सेकंड हा यूज करावा लागेल. तर त्यावेळेस म्हणजे दोन पैकी एखादी टर्म रिपीट झाला असेल तर काय करावं लागेल, वी विल सी दॅट रूल नंबर सेकंड. इफ टर्म ऑफ द form p of x divided by ax plus b cx plus d, in general I will write here yeah, then what we will do, firstly for this term as like in previous, write down a divided by, so write down here, then a divided by a x plus b, for this write down b1 divided by cx plus d plus b2 divided by cx plus d x square plus b3 divided by cx plus d its cube plus on bn cx plus d to the power n. तर बघा ह्या ठिकाणी जर असं असेल px divided by x plus b cx plus d चा पॉवर n, तर as like previously पाठीमागच्या सारखं a divided by x plus b, तर x चा पॉवर 1 आहे, पूर्ण ब्रॅकेटचा पॉवर किती आहे इथं 1 आहे, त्यामुळे a by x plus b सिंपल. पण जेव्हा cx plus d x चा पॉवर 1, रिमेंबर दॅट पॉवर ऑफ दिस x is 1 but power of this bracket is n, then you have to take the n arbitrary constant, means b1 b2 b3 up to the bn, and take this basic term and increase its power, means 1 2 3 4 up to the n. तर जेव्हा सी एक्स प्लस डी एक्स का पावर वन आहे आणि पूर्ण ब्रॅकेटचा पावर एन, त्यावेळेस ती बेसिक टर्म घेत राहायचं आणि कॉन्स्टंट याचा पावर पण एन आहे त्यामुळे एन्थ टर्म घेत राहा, बी वन बी टू बी थ्री अप द बी एन, म्हणजे एन्थ आर्बिटरी कॉन्स्टंट, आणि त्याच्यानंतर मग ते जे टर्म आहे त्याचा पावर वन टू थ्री फोर अप द एन. सो दिस इज अ रूल नंबर सेकंड. आफ्टर कम्प्लिशन ऑफ दिस रूल नंबर सेकंड वी विल सी द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ धीस इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. वी विल स्टॉप.